Fire Beats. How are you guys tonight?
Very good, thanks.
Very good.
Okay, you guys excited to play Create tonight?
Always, always.
It's great to be back here. I love this place.
Awesome. So my first, as we like start off this interview, what I'm gonna do is just start off with a little background. Tell me about your guys' background. I know you guys went to School of Arts in Tilburg, in the Netherlands. What were you guys' background? What
you guys were
doing before you two decided to
collaborate
together?
We have different, totally different backgrounds. I started out more as a total bass DJ in hip-hop.
And I started more with like real house music and stuff. Yeah, that's my background. Classical music, so it's a bit different approach.
Did you play drums?
I play the drums.
When you guys create music, as you guys were saying, what inspires you to create a
It can be anything. It's always a different approach. Sometimes we start with a melody, sometimes we start with a beat, sometimes we start with a sample. We really like samples, so that's always a big part in our songs.
Yeah.
But like I said, it's always different. Sometimes we go to a show and hear a song that we really love and we're like, we want to create something like that. Sometimes we listen to a totally different genre and we think, well, it's cool to make something like that in our songs.
It's kind of inspired by a track we did before that, because Bazooka kind of has the same vibe of it, and we created some of that stuff in the track, and Tornado, and just flipped it. And that real fire beat sound came back, and it worked pretty well.
It's all those booms and booms. I can see, you guys check your Instagram and your Twitter and social media a lot. You guys are traveling a hell of a lot.
Yeah.
How do you guys manage that with tour and everything? How do you guys manage to travel all the time?
Yeah, we try to stay a little bit healthy. Of course, we drink sometimes. But we try to work out. We try to get good food. That's for us very important. To check every the local best places. We always do. We are real food, so we're always trying to find a good spot.
What's your guys' favorite thing about touring and traveling? You said that.
Seeing all new, the shows of course, and seeing all these places. You get to travel to and all these new persons to meet. So it's really. Every day is different, so it's pretty cool.
So great. What's your guys' when you guys travel, what has been your favorite gig or festival or concert that you guys have
performed? I love Japan. It's really amazing. It's really sick. The people are so different. Yeah, it's really cool.
Show-wise, the EDC looks
good. Yeah. Vegas. Yeah. And with that, when you guys are performing at different shows, all these songs have really big beats per minute and pulses and how do you guys how do you guys pump yourselves up before
you perform a show? The major key is that we always have new stuff to play out.
Yeah.
So you're always excited to go on and see how the crowd reacts to the new stuff. So that's one big motivation to make a show great,
Awesome. A little birdie told me that you guys may be having some new releases coming out. Do you guys want
we have a lot of new stuff coming out. We got a new track with Luke and Steve coming up. And the first single on our own thing.
We start
our own label.
That lady over there.
That lady, she's sitting over there. She's amazing. We're going to perform it live tonight as well. We premiered at the EDC Las Vegas and it's going to be a huge song.
I can't wait to hear about it. Are there any background stories you might want to hear? For our exclusive subscribers.
We met Vertel, I think it's a year back now, in LA for a studio session, and we bumped out the track, and it was a day or maybe two, and then we finished it off, and now it's all done. It's going to be released on our new label, and so it's really exciting.
Love you guys, I've been a fan for
these
2 years. Speaking back to these artists, I see you guys have been well admired by famous DJs David Guetta, Steve Angello, Laidback Steve. What artists would you really want to collaborate with?
We already did one with Gil Panera, but I would love to do another one.
Alvin Harris.
Yeah, he's to something with Prodigy one day.
Yeah, Prodigy, you know,
besides music, like, what are you guys' other hobbies?
Like, I play soccer, I do some boxing, like, video games and shit. But it's always only at home with chill out, so with your dad.
What's your favorite video games?
At the moment, I play the new Zombies Call of Duty. Hey! I play that shit like all the time. I love that shit.
Zombie
shooting. Zombies. 24/7. That's good.
And so, I like thinking back on your guys' lives. Like, what was the most embarrassing moment? It doesn't have to be like musically,
it
can just be like individually, personal, funny.
That's a good one.
No.
I mean, sometimes it happens, and I can think of a specific one, but of course sometimes the music falls out, or, you know, yeah, and then you're like, then it's fucking awkward, but then again, I'll grab the mic and make something out of it. But that happened a couple of times. Yeah. I think that sucks, you know, that's really embarrassing.
But
yeah, that. And high-fiving someone, and he doesn't high-five.
Yeah, that's... Like,
that's always bad. I've had one of those before.
Everybody has that once in a while. So.
That happened to me like most of the time in high school. Right? So.
It happens.
Thank you guys so much for agreeing
to
come for your show. I'm so excited.
Cool. Thank you.